Howdy, welcome to Let's Play IL-2 Stormovic with me, Nob, ZXPK YanoBB. We'll continue on with the Stormovics of Ventria campaign today. We completed 13 missions, we died 14 times, we have a score of 3963, whatever that means. We have 1 medal, we only have 7 kills, which is good enough by me. We have 82 ground kills, which is insane. Alright, mission number 14, Busse's last hope. 26th of April, 1945, 6 a.m. What is clear, we're still at Westmalle Air Base. Look at this, Berlin is surrounded. Berlin is completely surrounded. That's another surrounded area over here. Looks like we'll be focusing on this surrounding. Alright, mission briefing. There were plenty of other smaller encirclements around Berlin. Many German units were cut off from the city before they could reach it, and now fought desperately to link up or to break through into their doomed capital. So yeah, that's what's happening. This is completely surrounded. They're trying to link up whatever Germans they had around here, but no, we blocked them off. So it's only a matter of time we suffocate Berlin and win the war. To the southeast, right here, that's where we are. One of the encircled units was General Busse's 9th Army with elements of Frankfurt on the Oder garrison. They received news that General Wenck's 12th Army to the west of their positions was attempting to fight their way through. Busse made a decision to advance towards Wenck, link up, and to combine forces to try to break through Berlin. So Busse was they were in here. Now they are here somewhere, and they're trying to break through to the west, link up with Wenck, who are, I'm not sure, maybe here, I don't know. They're probably out here, I don't know. But they're trying to get out to the west, and it looks like we're gonna try to stop them. The 9th Army attacked at dawn, I guess, D-A-W-N is a typo, on the 26th, which is right now. 26. So the 9th Army attacked it right now, pouring into a weaker spot in the rear guards of the 1st Ukrainian Front. So Ukrainian Front is here. German soldiers frantically clawed at their last chance, knowing full well they'd never get another. The IL-2s had been making their lives miserable for a few days, and after a counterattack had begun, the headquarters decided to send the IL-10s in as well. Alright, so good situation going on here. Strike the enemy vehicles in the counterattack region. A couple of taking off today. Each plane taking a pair of bombs and 2 pairs of rockets. Take off at 6 a.m. blah 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 blah. Maintain the altitude of 1,000 meters. The location of your target is marked on your map. The primary targets are the enemy vehicles and tanks. So we'll take off southwestward, and we'll just keep going straight basically. Altitude 500, 800, 500. 800, 500, I don't know. It says 1,000, but it doesn't say 1,000 anyway on any of these waypoints. Anyway, we'll take off, we'll basically go straight. We'll be looking for this 4 streams of water coming together here. And there's a bridge here. So we're gonna look for this bridge. And I think the German tanks and vehicles will come through this road and try to cross this bridge. And the Ukrainian front, which has moved on to here, some of them will back up to help help us stopping the German forces from getting across. So good enough. I don't think we'll have any problem finding that area. Although I think it's a new area for us. Let's do about 40% fuel throttle, low level bombing. 5 second delay. Instant. Delay. No, I want low level. Level 5 second delay. Great. So yeah, I don't think we'll have any trouble finding this area. I don't think we've ever been down here. Maybe we have. I can't quite recall. I know we fought around here before. But I don't think it's too hard to find. I think all we gotta do is fly straight and look for the 4 streams of water to meet, and look for the bridge, and then we'll find that road. And when we find that road, we'll find the vehicles, It's not gonna matter what kind of vehicles. They'll probably have tanks and trucks and cars and motorcycles. I don't know. They probably have. They're basically everything they got. They're moving out. I mean, this is their last chance. So they're sending out everything they have. All the lights on. I hear a whole bunch of planes. A couple of LAs flying by. An IL-2 flying out there. I hear another IL-2 up there. IL-2 number 5. IL-2 number 1. LA's number 1 and 2. Lock my tail wheel. This is my wingman behind me.
Get
to take off. Alright, everything checks out. Let's go. Turtle up. There's the tail wheel. Gonna go up. We're up in the air. Flaps. You see the pair of bombs underneath us? They'll drop at the same time. We have two pairs of rockets. Wings. It's the IL-2 again. I will climb to after the 1000. We're headed southwest. Good. And the LA's again. I see two more plants in front of everyone. I'm not expecting to see any enemy air resistance or any enemy airplanes. I do expect the vehicles on the ground to shoot back at us. And more IL-2s. Looks like they're coming this way though. So those two are probably the ones we read on the briefings. The IL-2s that made the German lives miserable. Let's not fly straight into them. Let's fly to the right side of them. They're coming back. They did what they could. These IL-2s are LAs and IL-2s are flying out there. They'll do what they can, and we'll fly in after them. All tens. Throttle down. All right, everything looks good. We are almost at altitude 1,000 already. Altitude 1,000 right now. Level out here. Throttle maybe 60%. For pitch maybe about 60%. This is the IL-2 number 5 we saw earlier. Probably IL-2 number 1 out there. The LAs are flying high in case the enemy airplanes come. That's a U-2 that's coming back. U-2 is an old biplane. Still being used at this time by the Russians, mostly for recon missions, I guess. Alright, there's a lot of waters here. I didn't expect to see this many streams of water, but I think we'll find one we're interested in. This isn't it. No, this is not it. Is this it? Yeah, I see some tracers. So yeah, I see the four streams of water. You see two streams out there and two streams over this way. So this is it. That wasn't too long. So another airbase out there in case we need to make an emergency landing nearby. But our airbase isn't too far away either. We're at altitude 900. So let's let these IL-2s do their stuff first. Yeah, I see some tracers coming across from the right side of the bridge to the left side. And there's the two streams of water. And there's two streams of water on this side as well. This is indeed the right spot. These IL-2s are gonna... IL-2 number one just dropped his bombs. I don't see anything. I see the road. I see something out there by the bridge. I see some white. Something out there. This IL-2, this shadow, dropping his bombs. Oh, I see some tank. I see a lot of cars and tanks out there. He just completely missed. But there are a whole lot of these guys. Wow, someone's shooting at me from underneath. Alright, so you see a column of cars out there. There's a block of cars out there. And they're shooting at me. And there's another column of car on the bridge itself. And some have crossed the bridge already. And I believe these are Russian and Ukrainian, I guess Russian guns shooting at these vehicles that's crossed. That's a big tank. Yeah, you hear that boom. That's a big tank. I'm not sure if I can kill them with my guns. But we have one shot of bombs. Even though we have two of them, we drop them at the same time. So we have one chance with our bombs. Then we'll have two chances with the rockets. I'm not sure whose vehicles these are. Not gonna blow these up. And then we'll of course have cannons and guns to spare. I haven't seen any enemy airplanes, so I think we can expand all our ammos on the ground targets. There's the bridge. If I had big bomb, I could just take out the bridge. Alright, hopefully my wingman is behind me. Alright, ground targets, attack them all. Alright, just starting his attack run. I'm gonna focus on that group of cars that was shooting at me. Keep the throttle up. On the radiator, lower the propeller pitch. I don't see them. I see them. I'm flying right at them right now. Drop my bombs right here. Get the hell out of there. I think I missed with my bomb. I don't know. Maybe my bombs didn't explode. I don't know. At any rate, I didn't kill them. Alright, it's my wingman. Don't fly into me, please. Well, I missed them. Now I'll attack with the rockets. I'm gonna fire all four of my rockets. Well, no, I just fire one pair. Hold on, I see a whole bunch of cars going this way. Whoops, wrong button. Yeah, I actually pressed the wrong button there. First pressed the cannon buttons, and then I pressed the bomb buttons. Just pushed just about all the buttons except for the rocket buttons. I found the rocket buttons. I was out of the... Alright, this time. Where's the bridge? There's a bridge. Alright, there are the cars. Fire my rockets. Missed. Oh man. I didn't realize they're gonna be shooting at me. Alright, well. I'm out of rockets. I'm out of bombs. I didn't hit anything. What I'll now do is come and fly from there behind, which is from the east. And I'll strafe them with my cannons and my guns. It looks like there's another column of cars right there. So so far I found maybe four columns of four columns of cars. There's a lot of cars out there. I really wish I could have hit them with my bombs. Oh, someone was just shooting at me from underneath. Still shooting at me from underneath. Turn around here. Scan this road. There's another car. There's the fifth column of cars. There's a lot of cars here. And we saw a lot of them off the road as well. Let's gain some altitude. Hang in there, Bob. It's a very unpleasant feeling to have blood rushing to your head. This is a fucking parking lot here. Let's see what's going on out here. Huge tanks. Huge tanks, they got across. Can't really stop them. Alright, so we'll keep attacking until we spend all our ammo. Let's see, Russian guns. Trying to stop those tanks. Now, I can't shoot at those tanks, but I don't think I can kill them with my guns and bullets. With my cannons and bullets. So I'm gonna go for the smaller targets. Now, those guys. There's three of them shooting up into the air. Hopefully, I can take out some of them in this run. Right, what else is on this road? It's another column of cars. Another column of cars. That's it. Hopefully. Are you still out here, man? Still attacking. Let's get behind them once again. IL-2 still sticking around. Do I have a shot at these guys? Don't have a shot at these guys. Whoa, don't shoot at me. Let's get out of here. We're gonna go crazy. I'm flying like a maniac. Can't help it. That's four big tanks that went across. Some smaller cars around here. They made a cross. And we should have just taken on this bridge. What? Just crossed the road. What the hell? It's weird. Alright. Some of these guys were firing at me. I don't know where they are, I don't know who they are. I just ran out of cannons. My plane is built like a tank, almost literally. So I can take a lot of damage. I got hit many, many times, but nothing. No scars or anything. Alright, so I'm out of cannons. I'm gonna do one more run with just my guns. Out of cannons, out of bullets. No, I have bullets. Out of cannons, out of bombs, and out of rockets. Now I can't take out some smaller cars with my guns, but that's about it. Can't really see them. Small trucks here and the big tanks. Oh man. Can't take those guys out. Alright, let's do one more run on our way back. And then we'll just head northeastward. Land at our air base. Alright, that's my wingmate still doing work, hopefully. One car here. No, couldn't get him. Out of ammo. Bingo ordnance. Nothing I can do anymore. Let's get out of here. Let's go home. Alright guy, let's go home. Navigate. Return to base. Alright. To the rising sun. So that wasn't good, but that wasn't bad either. Another day of work. All we gotta do is keep this up, and then Germany will pretty soon suffocate. Or Berlin will surrender, and that's about it. What? There's some more guys over here? Holy crap, how big is this army? And these guys I haven't seen. So there's yet another column of. There's another column out there. Oh, jeez. There's a whole lot of them. I didn't realize there's so many. So much. Any more? Hopefully not. If you rearm my plane, I'll come back and drop more bombs. I don't think I can do that here. Where's the airbase? That would be there by now. Ground control. Vector to home base. 030. Maybe to the left. Zero 030. Straight to not here. Altitude 560 or so. See any air bases. Alright, we are out of danger zone. Let's throttle back down 50%. Propeller pitch down to about 50%. here. I'm about 8. I'll cruise on out here. This IL-10 is pretty damn fast. Still going above 400 kilometers per hour. Are we there yet? 060 now. Man, I was heading 060 earlier. Right, so that's the river. Is this the city right there? Oh, okay, there's the airbase. This is the city of Forstenwalde. That's the airbase of Forstenwalde. I'll land from this side. That's what the briefing showed. I'm gonna raise back the prop pitch up to 100%. Throttle down. Open up the radiator. Fuel mixture has always been 100%, other than when I started my engine. My tail wheel is unlocked. I think I can land it from here. Let's throttle all the way down for now. Landing light, external lights. Ask for the permission to land. I don't think I have air brakes. That's a fine looking plane. IL-2 number 1's back. IL-2 number 5 or something still back there. IL-10 number 2, my wingman is behind me somewhere, hopefully. My speed of 260 right now. Check the head. Gears down. Flaps all the way down. Speed of under 200 kilometers per hour. Throttle up a bit. Throttle down to descend. Flare up. It's down. To the left, so that's where everyone is. I spent all my ammo, the rear gunner has just fired a single shot. Man, you guys parked right here. Hold up a bit. No one's coming this way.
Lights off.
So these two IL-2s, they were out there before we even took off, and they came back home. They look fine. Looks like they have a huge gun. I think these are big guns to take out the big tanks. We didn't have those. Let's see, what else is out there? So we are parked here. Some other planes are parked over there. IL-2s. IL-10, my wingman just landed. It's in taxing. Some probably the LAs and the other IL-2 probably circling around. No one in the AO area of operation right now. Looks like these big tanks are still marching on. See them? That's some of the smaller trucks they pulled through. There are still Russian guns around. And there's a lot more cars. It's like so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I don't know, probably 6, I don't know, there's probably 6 or 7 waves of cars, the columns of vehicles, just keep going on. But nothing after them. No, they're still after them. So still a couple more columns near Ryskov, I don't know. But we're here. No one around Berlin. Some cars out here. Let's see. Let's go through the vehicles. All the my wingman taxing like a champ. Here comes the IL-2 number 5. It's landing. It's got some writings and yellow stripe. How come I don't have a yellow stripe? Yeah, it's got big cannons and some rocket pods. Some LAs flying behind them. IL-2s are of course great planes. I like my IL-10s better. This is my land. Perfect 3-point landing.
Посадку не разрешаю. Уходите на второй круг.
Thank you for flying.
Ухожу на следующий круг.
Airplane fuck you up. IL-10, IL-2. LA planes with a big legal engine. Back to us, okay. There's no enemy airplanes. That's it. So we have a few more ground kills, not much else. We got some more points and I don't know, not really care about the points or the medals or even kills. Oh look, we are no longer in the Berlin area. We are now in over Manchuria. The Sea of Japan, this is Russia and parts of China and North Korea. So this is Manchuria. We're here finally at mission, 15 or something? This is the debriefing of what happened at the end of that war. The mission to suppress Busse's breakout near Fürstenwalde was the last my regiment. My regiment flew over Germany. By the 27th of April, the regiment existed only on paper. All our aircraft were either lost in combat or written off to other causes. However, both of our squadrons equipped with the IL-10s did complete their main task, which was to evaluate the new Sturmovik, to discover its strength and weaknesses, and to compile an evaluation report and recommendations for future use. Not many of our pilots were happy with the situation. We withdrew from the crucial battle at a crucial point. Yeah, we had that thing won, and it looked like the war would be won without us. Of course, we understood the importance of our task. Evaluation of new aircraft was vital to the war effort. However, sitting at a desk and writing out battle reports in our best handwriting was not how we imagined our evaluation of the IL-10s. We hoped to make an impact, to see our faces in the papers, to read articles praising our flying ability and our use of the new Sturmovik. As it was, we stuck our nose in and had the door slammed in our face. Between all the calligraphy, we listened to radio broadcasts and hounded pilots from other regiments to give us updates on the state of the war. So yeah, we had that thing won, and basically we were ordered to not fly anymore. Adolf Hitler committed suicide on the 30th of April. Germany surrendered and Zhukov on the 9th of May. The next few days were a haze of drinking and celebrating. By the 12th, our commanders finally started trying to get their regiments back together and to get us to finish our reports. It was the strangest feeling. All that was left of that all-consuming war was a blank piece of paper in front of you. And when that paper was finished, you'd be on the long train home. Most of us were in a complete shock over the thought of the post-war life. Most of our pilots enlisted straight out of high school, and only job they ever had was flying and fighting. Many contemplated staying in the army, but of course the Soviet Union would not need such a large army in peacetime, and we knew most of us would be discharged. Some of these shrewder pilots used all their spare time to study military textbooks and sent in applications to military academies. Others discussed stateside life to no end. How does one find a job? What jobs could one get with no experience and no education? Could they get into college at this age? Where would they live? Some of our pilots didn't even know where they would go. Their families, their houses, and often their entire villages and towns were wiped off the face of the earth by 4 years of war. Others' families had been evacuated beyond the Urals of 41, 42, and most haven't heard from them since. How would they find them in the post-war chaos? The report was finally completed a week later, and it was sent up to Kremlin to be read and signed by Stalin himself. The days after that dragged on, in endless wait for discharge papers, few of us didn't have a certain sense of dread when a young staff officer came by and told me to report to Regiment CP. I knew the time has come. Man, this thing's long. All right, inside, I saw more generals than I had ever seen in my life. General Pyotr Zvonarev, Chief of Staff, Air Army, startled me with a hug. "Sit down, Captain. Very glad to see you. How's the squadron doing on this fine day?" "Thank you, sir." I grabbed a chair. "We're doing great, although things could be better." "How so?" "Some of us are overwhelmed. It's difficult to adapt to peacetime. Some of the pilots are celebrating the victory day, if you know what I mean." "Yours isn't the only squadron I've visited, General Winst. Everyone needs some time to adjust. They're trying to think of a solution at the highest level, by the way. Where are you from?" "Sir, don't you have that in my file?" "A file's a file, but I want to hear it out of the horse's mouth." The general had a strange spark in his eyes, and I wondered if I was in some kind of trouble. "I'm from the Vladivostok region. I don't know where I'm from. A little hunter's village near Lake Kasan." "Why?" So a hunter from Primorsky Krai, been hunting in the taiga much?" What the hell is this guy talking about? "Yes, sir. Me and my father used to go out hunting a lot. The only way to get meat where we lived. Very plentiful around there. Game, fowl, berries, and mushrooms too." It was hunting for mushrooms. "Right. You miss home? Where's the last time you've been back?" "Where's the last time? You mean when's the last time you've been back?" "Hugh, sir, I haven't been back since October 37 when I joined the Air Force." "In that case, I have great news for you." My heart sank. The general got up and walked to the large map of USSR hanging on the wall with one L. "Look here, this is where you're from. It's pretty troubled region right now. Danger looming, as they say. The Japanese Kwantung Army is amassing on our borders. Over 1 million men. Our government is worried that Japanese aggressors are planning to attack the Soviet Union. along the entire border from the sea to the lake Kanko, you know what that would mean? Yes, sir, I was astonished. The Japanese wanted to attack us right after we beat their chief ally. I tried to gather my thoughts. Wouldn't be easy for them. It's just swamps and hills and little rivers everywhere. Not good for tanks, for artillery, and for Sturmoviks, of course. Yes, you're right. Keep listening, though. The general sat back down. Other generals gathered behind his back. VVS of the Pacific Fleet just formed a new IL-10 regiment. Plenty of good officers there. 10 to 15 years in the army. And none ever saw the combat. So they are as green as they could be. Maybe even worse. After flying over nothing but friendly territory for 15 years. You see what I'm leading up to? I nodded, attaboy. They need a veteran commanding them. Somebody with combat experience, some medals on his chest. We only have one medal. Somebody who knows how to lead his men in the battle. And if I can be frank, those Navy jerks think they know everything. So they need a landlubber to set them straight. You up for the job? I swallowed hard and began rubbing my forehead. Now that there was some unexpected change, I took a deep breath. That'd be wonderful, sir. I've been dying of boredom out here. Wonderful. I'm glad we have your real agreement to go with these orders. I really am. Of course, you get to go home and visit your family. Here you are 2 weeks, and we'll think about getting you into the academy. You're just the right type. Thank you, Captain. Finish up here at the regiment, pass the reins, and go catch your train. In your 2 weeks leave, the 2 weeks leave just started. Start. As I expected, the Navy types at the regiment. I guess I moved to this area now. So the 2 weeks have passed. A lot of stars have passed. As I expected, the Navy types at the new regiment didn't like me when I arrived. I could understand that. I immediately asked to fire up an IL-10, took off, and gave the scurvy dogs a little aerial demonstration. I doubt few of them had ever seen any plane, much less a Sturmovik, do maneuvers like that. My masterpiece, a wheels down, a loop on landing approach with touchdown and the lowest point sealed the deal. I can't do that. The entire regiment in the unfamiliar blue uniforms gathered around my plane and applauded. The rest would be easy. Soon the entire regiment knew I flew over 500 sorties. Have I? Really? I flew 15 sorties. Alright, personally, destroyed hundreds of enemy targets. Yeah, we almost destroyed hundreds of enemy targets. And instead of being shunned, I was looked up to all. All senior officers hung around me trying to make friends. Still, there were difficult times ahead. I had to teach these pilots how to use their IL-10s in battle. We flew every day, early morning to late afternoon, and then studied the classroom in the evening. I developed newfound respect for my comrades as well. Most of them were capable, experienced pilots, and many instinctively knew what I was about to teach them. So we are done with the campaign in Germany. We are now here in the east side of Russia. The Japanese are gathering up here. The Japanese forces are on the blue, I guess. They're coming from this side, I guess. I don't know. They're coming from the west side. It's August. We went from April, end of April, to beginning of August. So a good 3 months of rest, but no fighting, and then now we're back fighting. I'll be back in the next video, and we'll finally fly over Manchuria.